The next mode of operation I want to talk about is called Ctr mode, which stands for counter. We have a message divided into blocks, just as before. We'll have our encryption function, just as before, and we can think of it as AES or any other block cipher. And that takes a key as input. We'll use the same key. But instead of just having a message block go in, what we're going to do instead is have a counter, some value that cycles through the natural numbers. That's going to be our input message. So we'll get out of that some ciphertext. And what we're going to do now, well, so far, none of this has anything to do with the message, right? We've just encrypted the counting values from 0 to n minus 1. What we're going to do is XOR those, XOR the outputs here, with the message. So the message blocks go into these XORs, and what comes out is the ciphertext blocks. If we did it just like this, we wouldn't have quite as much security as we would like. We'd be vulnerable to attacks that search the space of counters. We'd also be vulnerable because we're using the same sequence of counters for every file that we encrypt with the same key. So the solution to this is similar to what we did with the initialization vectors in the previous mode. What we're going to do is add a nonce. We'll append the nonce with the counter value. And a nonce is very similar to a key. A nonce is a one-time unpredictable value. Unlike a key, it doesn't need to be kept secret. The point of the nonce is to make sure every time we use counter mode with the same key, we get different blocks out. So as an example with AES, if we have 128 bits as the block size, we might have a 64-bit nonce and a 64-bit counter. So let me summarize these two modes. So we saw cipher block chaining mode, and we saw counter mode. In CBC mode, the ith block of the ciphertext is the result of encrypting using the key, the ith block of the message with the previous ciphertext block. And we need a slightly special case for 0, which would use instead of the negative 1 ciphertext block, which doesn't exist, would use an initialization vector. With counter mode, the ith ciphertext block is the result of encrypting the value of I, that's our counter, with some nonce. And I'm writing this as concatenation. So we have 64 bits here pasted next to those 64 bits for the counter and the nonce. And that is XORed with the corresponding message block. To do decryption with counter mode, well, the ith message block is the ith ciphertext block XORed with this same value, which, as we know the key, we can decrypt. So that's how decryption is done. With CBC mode, the ith message block is the result of decrypting the ith ciphertext block and XORing that with a previous ciphertext block. Or in the case of the very first block, XORing that with the IV.